Hello everybody, my name is Walter and today I want to show you how you can build my 7x7 torch key double volt door, which you can see here right in front of you. So essentially it's a volt door that looks the same from both sides and has in total 10 integrated torch detectors. So you can place a torch on either of those 5 blocks on this side or the corresponding blocks on the opposite side and the whole door will start opening. And that looks like that, essentially. Then you can just walk through. And after it has opened, it starts closing once more. The time it stays open is easily adjustable by the amount of items in a specific hopper. I will come to this at the end of the tutorial. And, well, this time is easily adjustable and can be up to roughly 2 minutes. So, essentially that's how this thing here works. Now let's talk about the size of it. It's in total 24 blocks wide, has a length of 9 blocks. This also includes those walls above the ground and a total height of 16 blocks. Although as you can see in the upper corners there is a bit more space, but the rest is pretty much filled on in with redstone. So that's the size requirements. Now let's talk about the resources. You will need, of course, a lot of normal building blocks, then 55 obsidian blocks or other non-movable blocks, for example furnaces, then 12 glowstone blocks or upside-down slabs or similar, then 69 slime blocks, a total of 145 redstone dust, 34 redstone torches, 46 redstone repeaters, 9 comparators, 2 redstone blocks, 15 observers, 38 pistons, 69 sticky pistons, 8 hoppers, and a total of 34 eggs or other items with a stack size of 16. And that's basically all you're gonna need for this thing here. So all that's left now is showing you how to build this door here. Okay, so the first step is marking the floor at the center of the door. So this is the 7-block wide strip right at the middle. This can be normal blocks. Then go below and with a 1 high gap, place first 3 blocks like that. Then go down a block, place 3 blocks like so. Then another 4 in this direction. Then 3 to either side. Next, grab 2 repeaters, place them like that. Put them on 4 ticks each, and then put redstone dust on top of all those blocks here, finally a torch there, followed by 3 more blocks down here, another block up there, and then redstone like that. Next, place another block right in front of the redstone line, then go around the corner, place a repeater on 4 ticks right there, then put a sticky piston here with a block on top, then 2 blocks to this side here, redstone there, repeat on 1 tick here, then up with a block, then down and up again, another repeat on 1 tick in this gap, then go to this side here, go down towards the outside, then to this side here, up and down and once more up, so you get this little W shape here, put down 2 redstone dust there, repeat on 2 ticks here, torch here with a block on top and to either side, redstone on those 2 blocks and then torch blocks right next to the redstone and then mirror this to the other side. Then next grab a steel piston, place it on top of this block, then a redstone block right here. Next let's first place some timbery blocks with a 2 high gap here, so we can actually place a row of 5 non-sticky pistons, like that, followed by a row of 5 slime blocks right below. Then grab some sticky pistons and place a row of 5 like that. Then 5 normal blocks here. And then grab some obsidian blocks, place them around like so. And next you can actually fill in the rest of this side here with normal blocks. Then mirror this on this side again. Next, let's go to this side here where the redstone ends, and first let's go down here and place four blocks going around like that, then put two repeaters in the gaps on three ticks each, then three more blocks down like that with redstone on top of those four here, then quickly mirror this. Next, let's grab a sticky piston, place it here with a block on top, then blocks to either side, then up and down again. Redstone there and there. Repeat this on three ticks here and here. Finally, block right next to this sticky piston, then two and a third one here. Then redstone there. Repeat on four ticks and another one on four ticks here. And with that, we have pretty much finished this bottom part here, so let's quickly give it a try. For this, simply block this point here, and now this whole thing here should extend, then remove the block, and let's quickly put the torch somewhere here, and see if everything works properly, which it does seem to do. Now let's quickly put in a reset mechanism. So for this, just put the block here, then a repeat on one tick there, block here with redstone on top, then a sticky piston right on top of the repeater with a normal block. Make sure this is a full block. And then for now let's quickly grab a button. This is a temporary solution and just let's put it here. And this is our reset for later on. So next let's build the right side of the door. First, let's go here and place two blocks like that. Redstone here, torch on top, block here, a redstone on top, followed by two sticky pistons like that with normal blocks to the side. The same thing here mirrored. So redstone, torch, block, redstone, and the two sticky pistons with blocks to the front. And with that out of the way, let's go and first place two blocks going directly like so, then another three down like that, then two blocks like so, three blocks here, another three blocks like that. Grab some redstone and place it going along the way like that. Grab repeaters, place four on four ticks like that, put another block in this corner here. Then a sticky piston with a block on top, right there. Block here. With a repeater on four ticks in this direction, run us into a normal block. Another normal block right there. Another block in this corner. Redstone there, and a torch right here. Then block on top, torch to this side, to the outside. Then block on top, torch on top, block on top, torch to the inside. Another block on top, torch on top, to the side, and another block on top. Then go from this block two blocks inside, then another sticky piston here, then remove those two again. Place a total of four sticky pistons on top of each other like that. Then four slime blocks to the front with two more like that. Next, grab an observer, place it facing downwards on top of this slime block there. Then grab a normal block. Place it on this side here, then three obsidian blocks going downwards like that. Put redstone dust on top of those. Next, let's put a torch right here. And quickly grab two sticky pistons, place them here. Then it's time for two hoppers facing into each other right here. Take an output from this hopper here, run this into a normal block, then place directly a obsidian block, redstone there, grab a normal piston and place it here. This should be now directly to this observer there. Next, let's place three blocks like that, and the fourth one there, and the fifth one here. Grab three comparators, put this one here on the subtract mode. Then another block on top of this here, two redstone dust, one redstone torch here, then grab 15x and place it in this hopper here, and 5x in this one here. Then let's go down here again, place a torch on this middle obsidian block here, then directly a normal block, followed by a total of 3 more, so we have a total of 4 in this direction, then put redstone dust on top of those, then 2 glowstone blocks, again with redstone dust on top, then grab 4 normal pistons, place them going upwards in a stack like that, then 4 normal blocks right to the front. Then let's go to the opposite side here. First, place a block on top of this piston, then compare it in this direction. Block right to the face, followed by 2 more. Redstone dust on top of those. Followed by a torch right here, then diagonally another normal block, followed by 2 more. Then down one block, put redstone dust on top of those 4 blocks, then glowstone block up here, redstone on top, followed by another 4 normal pistons with blocks to the face. Next let's go and first place a block diagonally like that, then an obsidian block diagonally like so, redstone on top of this block, followed by 2 steel pistons like that, an observer right here, 2 slime blocks in front of this sticky piston, another sticky piston right below it, then 2 sticky pistons like that, 3 slime blocks like so, an observer facing downwards here with a sticky piston right there, then go to this side, place another 3 in an L shape like that, an observer in this direction, sticky piston to the front. Now to fill in this middle part here, let's first place immovable blocks to the sides of those wooden normal pistons here. Then go right here and place 5 slime blocks in front of those sticky pistons here. Then to this side 4 normal blocks and 3 on top. The same on this side mirrored. Then the row below, place in with alternating normal and obsidian blocks, not obsidian block right here in the middle. Then we can go to this block here, first place an L shape of 4 slime blocks like that, put 3 normal blocks around like that, and 5 immovable blocks like that, then a row of 4 slime blocks here with normal blocks to the face. Actually, don't forget to fill in this part here. And the same on this side here. Like that. Followed by a last row of normal, obsidian, then 3 normal, and normal obsidian normal blocks. And with that, this side should be finished, so let's quickly use our reset button here. And see if everything closes completely. And that looks good so far, so this is how it should look at the moment. And let's quickly see if the closing, or the opening also works. And as you can see, now we have a fully flat area again. So this means this side is actually finished. Which means it's time to build the second side. For this, let's first go down here, take an output with a repeat on 4 ticks in this direction, run this into a normal block, then up, down, and up again. Redstone dust here, torch there, block on top, then block, torch on top, block to the side, and block on top. Then make this here a row of 5 blocks, followed by a row of 3 blocks to this side. 3 redstone dust here, another redstone dust there. 4 repeaters on 4 ticks right here. Then sticky piston with a block on top, take an output with a repeater on 4 ticks. Run this into a normal block, block right there, then another normal block right here. Redstone there, torch on top here, another torch right there. Followed by a block on top, then 3 to this side, up and down again, and up again, then redstone dust like that, put one block here, redstone dust on top, another block right there, then block here, take an output of repeat on one tick, then block on top, torch on top like that, then grab two hoppers and go first and place them facing into each other right here where the middle of those three blocks is, put a torch right here, then put a block on below the sticky piston and a diagonal like so. In this gap place a comparator in this direction, redstone torch there, then diagonally some normal block of redstone on top, block here with a torch on the side of it, then blocks on top, then followed by two blocks in this direction, put down two repeaters on three ticks, the same on this side here, then put a block up like that, then go to the inside, put redstone dust on top of those two, then place two glowstone blocks with redstone top, another glowstone block right there. Next, let's grab an observer and place it right on front of this redstone here. Next, you can actually place 12 items in this hopper back there. And then it's time to place a sticky piston here with a block right to the face. Next, grab normal pistons and place them up like that for in total with normal blocks to the face. The same thing we basically mirror on this side here. After that, let's go right to the middle here. First, place two normal blocks there, two redstone dust down, and a redstone torch right there. Then grab an observer, place it here, facing in this direction, another one mirrored to this side, then blocks right behind them, and to the sides. Grab redstone, place them right there, repeat on four ticks here, and then two ticks there, again mirror this. Then grab some glowstone, place one block right there, then two normal blocks here, followed by two redstone there. Next, let's grab some sticky pistons, place a double piston extender here and there, with a column of four slime blocks in front of them, and normal blocks right to the face. And then let's grab some more obsidian blocks, place them down like that, four normal blocks right in the middle, followed by a U-shape of obsidian blocks like that. Next, let's go to the inside again, and first let's go to this torch here and place a block with a torch on top, then block on top, torch to the inside, block on top, torch to this inside, then take two hoppers, place them facing into each other on top like that, then place three blocks around like that, another block up here. Put down three comparators like so, this one here in the subtract mode, then one block on top here, two redstone dust and a torch right there. Next, place nine blocks in this hopper and 5x in this hopper here. Then go down here, place a temporary block right here, put a sticky piston on top, then you can take out those temporary blocks, and now place two more sticky pistons. Place three slime blocks going around like that, followed by a normal block right here, and then diagonally two more obsidian blocks, put down three redstone dust like that, then take an output with an observer from this hopper here, place two more slime blocks down here, and another observer right there, with a steel piston going towards the front, right here. Then it's time for another non-steel piston right here, so it would, when it extends, power or trigger this observer right there. Then grab some glowstone and place them right here, put redstone on top, then right in front of the redstone, two normal pistons, followed by two slime blocks and a row of three normal blocks. Grab some more obsidian and place them on top like that. Then go to the inside again, place a normal block diagonally to this torch here, then another block diagonal like so, and up here. Put down two redstone dust like so, then a block right in front of the redstone dust, torch on the side of it, block on top, then two sticky pistons like so, the same on this side here. So normal blocks, so redstone, then the normal block right here, torch, block on top, and the two sticky pistons, and then normal blocks to freeze, obsidian blocks here where the slime blocks get involved, and then the rest can be filled in with normal blocks. And that should be pretty much all of this half, so let's give it a try. So let's quickly reset it. And that looks good so far. Now let's see if it closes properly. And that's looking good. So all that's left is building the top part and later on an automatic reset. So for the ceiling, start right in the middle and place the first few blocks of the ceiling itself. So two normal blocks to either side, followed by three obsidian blocks in the middle. The fourth one up there. Then, going from the side we built first, so in this case the right side, place a repeater on one, two ticks in this direction, and the second one in the same direction there. Then blocks right here, followed by obsidian blocks here and there, the same on this side mirrored. Put redstone dust on top of those blocks, and those blocks here. Then place another block right here, put a repeater on two ticks in this direction, take an output with observers in those two directions here, then blocks on top, another block right here, the same on this side, redstone there and there, repeat on two ticks in both directions, then take again an output with observers, this time in this direction here. Next, let's grab a normal piston and place it below the observer, right there. Next, go to the side with the observers again, then place blocks on top of those redstone here and on top of this repeater. Then two redstone dust here, followed by two repeaters going outwards on four ticks each. Next, grab a sticky piston, place one here, another one below it, followed by a slime block, the same on this side here. Then you can already place one obsidian block diagonally to the slime block. Next, grab three sticky pistons and place them in a row like that, with slime blocks below and normal pistons right next to them, and finally a row of five sticky pistons one layer below with normal blocks on top and a redstone on top. Now just mirror this. So the three sticky pistons, slime block and normal piston, followed by the five sticky piston and the blocks of redstone on top. And with that, it's finally time to connect it with the rest of the entire thing. So first go to the right side again, put two blocks diagonally like so, redstone on top of those two, redstone torch here, block on top, torch to this side, block on top and to the front, then three blocks here, followed by four blocks like that, and finally some redstone dust now connecting the entire thing. And with that, it's finally time to fill in the ceiling. Just make it flat with normal blocks. We already placed all necessary immovable blocks earlier today. And with that, it's finally time to try the reset once more and see if everything works. Oh, I forgot those blocks here. And that looks good so far, so let's see if everything opens. And that looks also very, very good. Okay, so now the last part is actually building an automatic reset. So for the automatic reset, let's just go to the right side. First remove the temporary button here. Of course, if you want to have a manual reset, you can leave it as this or run a line of redstone in here. But for the automatic reset, we will have to remove this button. And first place a torch right here, then two hoppers facing into each other like that. Put a total of 16 items in here. The minimum is 16 items. Every item more means the door stays open for 4 ticks or 4/10 of a second. But 16 items is the minimum. This means that once the door has opened, it will at once start closing again. Then let's put a block here so we can take an output from this hopper here, which should be at the moment empty. Then put this in a block, then another block right here with redstone on top, block diagonally and a torch right here. And with that, the whole door should actually start closing. And now let's see if the whole thing works properly. And that looks good so far. Okay, with that out of the way, the last part is actually building some walls to hide the redstone. And you should be left with something similar to this here. Now let's quickly make two little modifications I just figured out to make this thing here roughly 1.5 seconds faster. And for this modification we'll need an additional redstone torch and an additional redstone repeater. And for this let's start on the left side. So here we have those two redstone lines that will be have to be removed and replaced with a repeater here on one tick. Then on the right side, let's go down here and first move this up by one block. Redstone on top, then another block raised here, redstone on top, block to the front with a torch to the side, block diagonally, some redstone running into this block. And now the entire thing opens just as fast as before, but the closing is now 1.5 seconds faster. So as you can see, now this whole thing here closes much smoother and faster. Okay, so that basically concludes this tutorial about my 7x7 double volt door with integrated torch key devices. I hope you enjoyed this little tutorial, and well, see ya!